everybody, and welcome to Wine Library TV. I am your host, Gary Vaynerchuk. C-H-U-K bloggers out there, you keep putting in that C. It makes me sad. You're throwing up the double C. And welcome to Wine Library TV. This is the Thunder Show, a.k.a. the 19th best show on the internet that has to do with wine. Today we're going to talk about Amarone, one of my favorite types of wine from Italy, bar none. I love Veneto, I love the area, I love the food, I love the cuisine, which is the food, I like the wines. We're just loving this place, and I've done many episodes on Amarone, so if you want backstory on how the wines and the grape, which is Corvina in these Amarones, if you want some backstory, the process, things like that, check out episode 67, 193, and 34. But today, it's Friday, but it's Tuesday, and I just did that big show that you saw last Friday. Sorry, no Monday show. Just couldn't sneak them all in, so I missed you yesterday. I'm probably flying back right now from Napa. Spent 2 days there, Monday and Tuesday. And so I'm going to just relax and drink these wines. You can get all your info from those three episodes. But today I'm going to have a lot of fun. Drink, taste, and enjoy these wines in front of you so I can rub it in. It's what I like to do. So let's start off with the San Rustico 2000 Amarone Gasso, single vineyard, $27. And that's what's really important about this wine and why I wanted to have it on. One, it's got a great track record. And two, it's got a great price for Amarone. Because these really kind of sneak up in price. And so I wanted to find one that kind of would be a little bit more moderate. Definitely still a special occasion wine at 27 bones. But definitely something that is a little bit more approachable than some of the $40, $50 ones that we've got coming. One thing I adore about these wines, as you know, I'm a huge fan of the bouquet, the nose, as I like to call it. And so Amarone always brings the thunder in that category. That's what I really adore about these wines. Much, much more probably than even the flavor profile, the aromatics on this red wine is just exquisite. So let's sniffy sniff. See, we can make that tough. Sniffy sniff this wine. I could do it all day. What gets me so excited about these wines is the licorice component, the dry raisin, the viscous aspect on the nose on these wines. They come with an enormous amount of that quality. The Gasso here from San Rustico is absolutely bringing that to the table. Beautiful dark black cherry Kirsch Royale licorice liqueur aspect on the nose. Just gorgeous. Let's give it a sip. A whirl, as some people say. Very young still, as a 2000 vintage. Very tannic and very hot. 15.5 alcohol content on this wine. And I'm feeling it. It's a little too hot for me and a little misbalanced because of that. Still has beautiful purity of fruit. Just gorgeous fruit and really luscious and solid and exquisite in that category. But the heat gets off on it and that makes this wine off-balanced. It's a little bit more matured. We're not talking about 2005 at this point. We're talking about 2000. So at this point, I'm going to be concerned that this wine is a little too over the top with the alcohol. It's got a nice finish, but again, the heat is clear. I absolutely feel like I just took a shot of Everclear and then drank some wine, which is a good thing for many of the people watching, CKCs. But definitely something that I'm not looking for in this bottle of wine. Even at $27, I'm going to have to give this wine a major pass. I'm going to score this wine 85 points. Standard mill of the run of the mill wine, and just not something I'm going to recommend. Let's move on. Allegrini 2003 Amarone. This wine is 90 points from the Wine Spectator. It's brought in by Leonardo Acasio, and this wine comes in at $57. So it is definitely a pricey Amarone, one that we've had tremendous pedigree with. I've been carrying this wine since basically the 90 vintage. I remember carrying this wine. So this has got a long pedigree, really interesting and intriguing wine. Some of the best Amarones I've had in that 97 vintage, 95 even, was tremendous from these guys. So I'm a big fan of these wines for a long, long time. 57 bones is really getting up there. Big big shout out to Mo Lewis, number 57, one of my favorite linebackers of all time. Let's give it a whirl. Smell first. This is 15% alcohol content. What people really, you know, Amarone is really interesting because I do get a lot of people that email me and tell me that Amarone is really their favorite wine, and I believe it's because of the residual sugar that these wines get. Sugar tricks us in America. We're suckers. We're sweet-tooth Americans. It's who we are. We're STAs. And so, you know, that's really what always comes through. Now, this on the nose is kind of funky. Almost smells like helium balloon, or, you know, kind of like a gas component coming through. Maybe I'll sip it and start talking all like, you know. So, on the nose, I'm getting that real obvious chemical component. I'm getting a little bit of charcoal, but not too much else. Let's give it a whirl. Young, clearly young. 2003 is a very young time to, you know, vintage for Amarone. It's got some beautiful mouthfeel, and it's very dry, much drier than the San Rustico. Great complexity. What I like about Amarones is these wines go tremendous with wild boar or really exotic game meats, something that I personally get into quite a bit. I find them to be tremendous compliments to one of my other favorite things in the world, which is gnocchi, which is my favorite pasta. You like gnocchi? Oh, Mott is so wrong. Mott's missing out. More gnocchi for me. Love it. And I love to pair them with Amarones. This wine is solid. It brings some good balance. It's well made. It's structured. I'm going to go 89 points on this wine. I can't get too crazy about it, but it's definitely, you know, a solid, well-made wine. 57 bones. With due respect to Mo Lewis, I'm going to have to give this wine a pass. Let's move on. Tomasi Amarone, 2001. This wine is 92 points from the wine enthusiast and 46 US dollars. Let's give it a whirl. A little bit more toned down right now. You know, many of you watched Friday's episode. I pretty much got nothing left. I almost had to take a nap after that last 4 minutes. Let's give this a little bit of a sniffy sniff. Ah, the Randalina. Another grape you find in Amarone. Kind of comes through on the bouquet with that violet aspect. I really like it. Violet. That sounds like violence. That's how it's... Say violet like violence. Violet. It's fun. Beautiful bouquet, very aromatically interesting because it comes a lot more floral than I'm used to. I'm used to that dry raisin, caramelly kind of aspect. I'm not getting that quite as much in Tomasi. Let's give this a whirl. Good solid mouthfeel. 2001 is a strong vintage. Gets a little minty there in the mid palate, which is extremely exotic and different for an Amarone. I like the overall complexity of the wine. The structure's right. I like the mid palate. The transition flavor from the mid to the finish is quite nice, actually. It gets very dark chocolate and almost caramelly. The finish is nice, but a little weak. Kind of disappears a little bit. But I've got to tell you, it's definitely the best of the three. I'm going to go 90 points in this wine. I kind of like it. I have to admit, though, at 46 bucks, I'm going to have to give it a pass because, I mean, unless you can afford it, you know, I just don't see the overall enormous value in spending 46 bucks for a wine that brings, you know, 90-point caliber stuff, especially when you could probably find a couple of Valpolicella or Rapasa, and we'll get into that on another show. Save that. Put that in your pocket. Rapasa. You know, so, I don't know. Nice wine. Very good. If you see it on a list and nothing else, it's definitely worth ordering. Heck, it's even pretty good. I may even take a bottle home. I kind of like it. But, you know, again, you know, dollar for dollar, I don't know. Let's move on. And this is the ringer. And this I'm excited about. This is actually Redhead Studios, Pieri Azzardo, Shiraz. And they call it Shiraz in an Amarone style. So it's kind of very interesting. A little new wave. It's 29 US dollars. And what they mean by in an Amarone style is, I'm sure that they, you know, I haven't done even the homework yet, but I'm sure that this means that they've done the whole drying the grapes out and that whole nine. You can do your own homework. Google it up. Badge me up. Friend me up. You know, all that's a dig, right? Dig, come on. Dig me. Dig me. All right, let's get us a whirl. The Oak Monster has finally made his appearance in a big-time way for the first time in a long time. And uh-oh, just like Chewbacca brought out his entire crew in episode 3, I think the Oak Monster is bringing all the Oak heads and his cronies out. And I don't know if I can defeat him because I'm only one man. And this wine is bringing some serious Oak. It is extremely over the top. This is Red Bull on a nose kind of action. Very oaky. I also get a walnut maple syrup component on the nose, which I have to admit is completely seducing me. I like it. It's very rich, very explosive. Every single Old World fan watching, and a friend of yours that is also an Old World wine fan, he needs to leave the room in his house because this is way over the top on the nose, and I haven't even tasted it yet. Let's give it a whirl. ...2005 vintage. There's a time and a place. There is a time and a place for this wine. That is a very rare occasion. It's when you got 15.5 alcohol. It's when you want to stuff an enormity of fruit and oak into your mouth and then light it. It completely explodes on your palate. It is very jammy and dumb. You know, it's like, it's goobery. It's kind of like the oofiest wrestler in WWF history, like Bastion Booger. I mean, just like a big, just like lands on you and he wins. Ding, 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 Bastion Booger won again. That's what this does. It is not very focused, and I would not say is the most complex, thought-provoking wine I've ever had in my life, but it's like the biggest kid you've ever seen in fourth grade. He's still gonna dominate most games, and that's what this does to your palate. This wine completely intensifies and just attacks the crap out of it. If you're a fan of big over-the-top wines, you have to seek this out. This is an adventure kind of like Goonies was, and that's a classic movie. I'm gonna score this wine. This is the kind of wine you can score 60 points or 100 points, 80 points. It's really, this is classic for your own palate. For me, 2 over the top. I'm gonna go 86 plus points on this wine. However, there are people that are gonna line up and kiss this frog and love it. Turn it into a princess or a prince immediately. Interesting. Question of the day. What wine would you like for me to taste on Friday's show? On the couch. I want to make it real cool. I want you to pick it. I'm going to pick 4. No, let's go 3. Make it real exclusive. I'm going to pick 3 wines for next Friday's, this upcoming Friday's couch episode, and you guys are going to pick it. Make sure you put in the link from winelibrary.com's page or any page. I'll have to go seek it out. So better if it's in our inventory. And we will do it on Friday, and 3 lucky winners will also get some swag, maybe free shipping. If we pick yours, you're gonna win. I don't know how we're gonna pick it. Maybe we'll do a drawing on Thursday, because that's kind of cool. Because that's the kind of things you do when you're changing the wine world. Because you and a little bit of me, I hit my nose, we're changing the wine world, aren't we?